Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? There is a new star, sort of, in the constellation of Delphinus. On August 14th, Japanese amateur astronomer Koichi Itagaki of Yamagata discovered a nova using a 180mm reflector telescope. That's right, a plain old amateur astronomy-sized telescope, not much larger than this one. How cool is that? How can we find this new star in the night sky? It's actually pretty easy. First, locate the summer triangle stars, then the Northern Cross within Cygnus. Using binoculars or a finder scope, and beginning at Deneb, hop the three more stars to Albireo. Now, this is the lovely double star that has blue and gold components, worth a look with a telescope if you're already there. Then continue almost on the same line, jogging slightly this direction past this double star, and winding up at the Coathanger cluster, or Colander 399. We'll follow the line made by the bottom of the coat hanger to locate Alpha Sagittae, which means we'll move in this direction, opposite the open end of the hanger's hook. This is one of our farthest hops, and yet it's only 7 degrees, about a finder scope field of view in total distance. Okay, so, you found Sagittae the arrow, yes? Not too bad so far, right? Now comes the hard part. Back faster than a nova flash! And now this week's dark sky fact. Dorset County in the UK recently turned off streetlights from 1 to 6:30 a.m. and found, unsurprisingly, as light pollution reduction advocates know, that crime did not increase. Police and Crime Commissioner Martin Underhill said there is no correlation between crime levels and changes to street lighting. Sagittae pretty much fits in a binocular's field of view. With several fourth and only one third magnitude star as the brightest four, it isn't exactly a standout constellation. Looking in the direction of the tip of the arrow, we'll see a fifth magnitude star. From the tail feathers to that star, the constellation is all of 6 degrees in length. Moving with the arrow, estimate just under that, about 5 degrees, and you will be at this 5.7 magnitude star in Vulpecula. Now these sixth magnitude stars are nearby to there. Note how these ones create a nice triangle. With the nova there, though, what you will see instead is a diamond shape, with the nova lying on this part of the diamond. So, there's the nova. Remember, this will be correct orientation in binoculars, but likely reversed in a finder scope, unless you have a correct image-style finder. Now, the other way to find the nova is from Delphinus. If you can see that constellation under your skies, look for the diamond shape in the dolphin constellation, draw a line through these two stars, and move that way about 6 degrees from Alpha Delphini to find our other, slightly dimmer diamond, and there you go. A few points. On Thursday, when I looked at this nova, it was similar in magnitude to these two stars in our diamond shape, but by Friday night, it was brighter than the 5.7 magnitude star. However, it appears to have peaked in brightness earlier that day and is already dimming. So, check the link I have at eyesonthesky.com to see a current light curve so you will know about what magnitude to estimate for you viewing this nova. That will help you spot it, knowing what brightness of star you may expect to see. Binoculars will get you to magnitudes 6, 7, or 8, depending on your local light pollution, but you will want to use a telescope if it's much dimmer than that. The low angle of the ecliptic in the evening keeps the visibility of Venus within 15 degrees of the horizon, while a few hops away is Saturn, just past Spica. In the morning sky, Jupiter is both bright at negative 1.6 and riding high in Gemini by 5 a.m., while the sky is still dark, though nearby Mars is also seen but dim at magnitude 1.8 and small at only 4 arc seconds across. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.